Have you ever felt?
Are you listening? Damn.
I could be wrong, and like everybody could be wrong, right? But the thing I'm going to say, I'm like 90%, 99% sure that it is correct. And what I'm going to say is, I would like to say congratulations, guys. Unfortunately, not because we see this rise and I think that this is a bull run. No, I don't think that it is. But I would like to say congratulations, because if you are those who bought at whatever price it was, whatever it will be, all-time high or 6,000, and you try to average down and you still didn't sell your Bitcoin or altcoins even, and you're holding and you didn't fall into the FUD, and you're trying to look positive and just base your decisions on the fundamentals instead of the hype or like things which are very changing very fast within days or even hours, don't fall into the sentiment of the crowd, then you're the one of those who probably will hold until the next all-time high of Bitcoin. And you will be one of those who will get the best, the biggest profit, especially if you will have even more courage and buy at the dips, whatever it would be, 3,100, 3,200, $1,000 per Bitcoin, whatever. If you will do that, you will be, we will have the greatest profits. I absolutely believe that. Otherwise, I wouldn't be doing these videos. I wouldn't be investing myself. And the thing is, at this particular moment, because we see this drop from $6,000, especially since it was preceded by the drop from 20,000 to 6,000, now a lot of people are so frustrated and so even angry on what is happening. And I completely understand this anger. They just don't believe that it may work. They think that, even some people think that it is a complete scam and it's already done, and whatever news we see is just manipulation, and we will see the drop even further down to $100, $10, and it's just exit scam. It was all Ponzi and so on. I tend to think that this is all wrong. I tend to think that it is exactly the thing which they want us to think. When I say they, those who are trying to make money on this market and have more tools than we have, regular people. And these drops, this price manipulations are the tools which make you think that it's over, that it is done, right? So you're about to sell everything and never buy again. And if you do that, they will buy. Just believe me, they will buy. And it happens through the whole history of markets. And if it would be an exclusion, when the fundamentals are strong, when it's something like new internet or whatever, but we will go to zero, it could pop. It is possible, right? I don't say that this is absolutely impossible. No, it is possible. However, it is so unlikely that I don't see how it can go wrong. Anyway, apart from those philosophical thoughts, let's talk about the daily activity of the price. So what we see now is we see some bounce from $3,100 something, and basically we pinned a little bit through the 20 to 200 days weekly average, to 200 weeks moving average, which was on Bitstamp. And now it was a very strong line to of support, and we needed to have a bounce from that. But even from such a strong support line, this bounce is so much inconvincing, in my opinion. Although it looks actually pretty bullish short term. You see this rise, correction, rise, some consolidations around this area. However, we bounced off this strong level so sharply twice already. Of course, we can try to pin it. If we will, then we may see some more correction up to even like 3,500 or something. But technically, I think it would be more likely to it more likely will be the like a false break upwards if you consider this wedge, and considering even the volume, it's just laughable. So I still look very bearish to me, and I'm looking forward to buy this green zone, which I depicted around here, and maybe sell eventually on some pullback. So that's the whole strategy: buy low, sell high. It's very easy, but the devil is in the details, so pay attention, guys. Of course, I'm not a financial advisor, and make your own decisions on your own. Everything is really dangerous around here, so it's up to you. I just share my thoughts here on this channel. Okay, so this is the daily activity. Also, if you look at the altcoins behavior right now, we are seeing a lot of the altcoins, for example, like Litecoin went 11%, more than 11%. Although Bitcoin just 2%, Litecoin 11%, Bitcoin SV more than 10%, Dash almost 10%, and so on. Bitcoin Gold, laughable Bitcoin Gold, more almost 10%, and so on and so forth. I think that it's too strong reaction for such a small increase in price. I think it smells like a bull trap for the altcoins. One more bull trap. And I think that although it would be very, very, like almost beautiful and elegant if we will not go to $3,000, which a lot of people expect, but go up from that. But I just cannot believe that. If it would happen, I will be happy. You see, if we will start to have the rise, the bull market from now on, I will be happy. But I would play safe, and I put us the buy order around here, and I will sell some in the profit, and I will buy even lower if it will go down. That is my strategy. Up to you guys. Again, we are approaching this psychological level of $3,000. Which is very important, and I think it's very likely to collect a lot of the panic sells at these levels. Also, we are approaching the $100 billion overall market cap for the whole crypto, which is also very important. If we'll pin it down, it's also leads some additional panic sells. And I must say something not really pleasant, but I need to say that if you look, for example, the historical price action of Bitcoin from 14th years, then a lot of people are comparing this, and there are a lot of reason to do that. So you see, if you would, it was pretty much similar to our current condition. So they had a lot of the fall during the whole period, like few months, and then they touched some, and see, there is no reason to expect that it will stop. It seemed like it will go to like zero or whatever, $1, and then it stopped finally, and then it goes sideways. When sideways, it was some kind of pullback, like V-shaped pullback, quite of like 50%. So it was quite strong pullback, but then it was a lot of oscillations around this area. The thing is, we may see the same thing, exactly the same thing, and only after like a year or nearly a year, it has some strong increase in price and some more confidence return and so on. So if this would be, for example, $2,000, then this would be like $3,000 or maybe $4,000 max, and we will continue to trade below like $5,000 for months, probably, like really likely to happen. And then eventually we'll start to rise. The thing is, I hope that with all the institutional money, they want to make it a little bit faster, unless they want to accumulate even more, unless they are so greedy, which is beyond all the possible limits, which is really possible actually, which is really likely that much of greedy. Although you can see actually no volume here and so on, very similar to what we have now. So just be careful guys with that. And let me show you this plot which I just made without any kind of attempt to predict the price action in the future. However, what I was going to say with this sort of chart, I wouldn't be surprised if, let's say, we will go down at this point down to $2,000, then correct to, let's say, even nearly $4,000, something like that. Then we'll have a pullback, then we have a long sideways trading, even with this maybe some decline, and then correct upwards, then go up again down, and then basically a lot of time. I don't say that this will happen exactly with the same time period. It may happen within like few months or a couple of years. I just made here, it doesn't matter, just the general behavior could be like that. So we will trade here for a while, and all of that will happen below $6,000, and then eventually we will break it, we'll have a correction, go up. It's a really strong level right now, right? So we'll go up and then correct it, maybe sideways trading for a while, maybe some abrupt drops to something like this, and then eventually we shall break this all-time high that was at 20k, and then we will go something like, I don't know, $100,000, whatever you like to be there. It depends on the market and everything, but just looking at this price action eventually in hindsight at these certain points, if we'll be holding strong, and if we'll not sell but buy at this low levels, and we'll live up to new all-time highs or at least some higher points, we will look at that and would say, well, yeah, it was obvious then, after such a huge jump we need to go down, and it was a great correction, and then we had this V-shaped reversal, some shaking out the weak hands, whatever you call them, and then some long accumulation period with a huge area actually from whatever $2,000 it would be until maybe $6,000 or $7,000, and then with new regulations, new fundamentals, and new institutional investors and everything, new capital coming to the place, we are about to grow and grow and grow in the previous actually even previous all-time high, which was pretty significant, pretty strong, would seem, and even this drop would seem very, very small, like a week, as we look at the same small all-time highs happened before. So guys, this is very easy to be smart and wise when you look at this situation from the future, when you already had this before, and you, especially if you live through that, and you'd say, yeah, it was obvious then it would happen. Now we have all this pain, all this FUD, all this fear that will go to zero, whatever, and a lot of the people just so much spreading the FUD again. Yeah, however, I would continue stand on the point that it's not true. And I already mentioned this many times in my previous videos, and I will continue to say that just the potential, the fundamentals, the technology is there. I don't care about the price. If this will not happen and this will not happen, we will think that this is the great technology. It may be the future. And it's just time to buy, because any next day it can moon. And that's why I still believe that it could happen, and it must happen actually, just based on the major probabilities and so on. Okay, but another thing is that, as you may know, as we discussed already that several times, if you will look at the traditional markets like stocks, for example, S&P and Dow Jones and Nasdaq, they closed last week very bearish, very close to the previous minimum, and it seemed like they are about to go even lower. So if it would happen and they will break like maybe somewhere here, maybe it will be like 20% or something below all-time high, lower than all-time high, then like erasing all previous gains, a lot of people will sell. So actually you can see the 200 days moving average around this area. It was going up and up and up and up and up, and now flat. If it will go down right now, actually you can see a little bit of the sign it will go, may go down. If it will, then oh my goodness. So global financial crisis may be just behind the around the corner, guys. And if it is so, then people will need to hedge their capital somewhere. Speaking about this, actually, this is DAX, is the German stocks index, and it's even worse comparing with NASDAQ. You see the sharp drop in the price low to this indices, low to like maybe previous year, November, end of November, December, something like that. Very, very bearish. And it may be like a domino effect and will crash all the other markets, including maybe the last ones, but still including American markets for equities. If it will happen, where the money should go? Traditionally, the hedge for this period of time is precious metals like gold. You see, recently, from 2013, gold, actually before, this was the max on 11th, and then it went down until 15th, and then we had some correction, and basically it showed this triangle, which technically possibly could break up. However, there was some optimism here in the global markets, so probably a lot of capital didn't want to be very cautious and try to risk a little bit more, so the gold dropped because of that. But now it is going up. Very nice indicator of the scared investors along the space, all over the place. And you see, if it will break this level eventually, it means that people are going to some safe havens, some assets which are more stable, like gold. And the same, well, similar with the silver happens these days. So silver is testing its bottom, and now it's, instead of breaking this bottom, it seemed to be like flattening and about to go up again from this point. Not mentioning also, well, we'll mention it, uranium was dumped so hard from 2011 when it was like those Fukushima events, and like what it was, $100, and now we have $12. It's just like Bitcoin, but slower. And see the volume around this level. It's such an accumulation point. Of course, it may go even lower like Bitcoin, but considering the overall market situation, I would tend to believe that it must go up, especially if equities will go even lower. The capital must go somewhere. Although it's not the, like, of course, the uranium itself, it's the companies which mining uranium, etc., etc. So it not exactly represents the price of uranium itself, but still, it is rather a signaling point. So what I'm going to say, guys, what I'm going to say is hold your coins and think positive. That's the what you need in such bear market. Just forget about your investment. You just think that you throw that money away, and just it's like you don't have it, okay? And within a few years, I don't know, 3 years, 5 years, whatever, I hope faster, maybe within the months, few months, you will look at the news and see, oh, Bitcoin actually is like broke previous all-time high. Okay, probably my portfolio is doing great. So I wish all of you this to happen. And the last thing which I'm going to mention is this, like a couple of news about the altcoins. Charles Hoskinson brings smart contract innovation to Cardano. I mentioned Cardano several times before, and I think it's one of the most promising like high tier altcoins among the others in terms of the risk reward ratio and the growth potential. I wouldn't be surprised if Cardano one day will replace those which are in the second positions, will be like whatever XRP or Ethereum. I think it has the greatest potential to go there. And in fact, what this means is that in general terms is that okay, what are the platforms for ICOs right now? Ethereum, which dumped so hard and people are scared about it. EOS, which has a lot of fundamental problems. NEO, which is very similar to Ethereum and not so many are happy about it, except me. I'm happy about NEO. Anyway, a lot of people are looking at Cardano. Cardano has the greatest fundamental platform, and they look so long term. They scrutinize all the like smallest details about the tech. It may be very likely may happen that they will end up with the greatest product for those ICO launching in 2019 in the next bull run, whenever it will happen. So it may be an amazing return in Cardano. So that is my opinion, not financial advice again. Second thing is XRP news confirmed. American Express is officially using Ripple's XRP news today. It's a bit of a clickbait, yes, but still the major point is correct. They have the sort of a partnership, and it is really, really huge. As I already mentioned before, XRP, or actually Ripple, has one of the greatest marketing teams, and the efforts in that is amazing. And they are trying to push it even further. If they would continue to do that, and if the market will be a bit reversal, see some of the reversal at least, then XRP will probably crush it. I think, like, if Cardano is the biggest performer in the next bull run overall, then XRP is probably one of the fastest. Again, just my opinion, but those guys are huge. Okay, I hope it wasn't that boring. If it wasn't, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel and leave your comment down below. Speaking about the comments, you may notice, if you're not the new to the channel, that I don't use music today. The thing is, I got some comments that it shouldn't be there. So I will leave two comments under this video from myself. And one of the comments will be, I shouldn't use music as a background. Please leave a like if you think so. And the second comment will be, I shall continue to leave to have the music as a background for my videos. Please leave a like if you agree with that statement. With that said, I would like to say safe trading, guys, and hope to see you tomorrow, because those updates are daily updates. I'm doing this every single day for you. So again, don't fall into the FUD. Stay strong and hope to see you tomorrow. Thank you for being with me through the whole this video. Goodbye, guys.